We've got a lot of positive going in the beginning, but it felt like it was a very long time to get back. don't take care of our natural resources, all of us don't do something to make a difference. If we lose it, we're not going to be much, our heritage, America, will not be very good anymore.
So, Chuck, I have to ask that. Is your dad and his brother, are they competitive still? Do you have any great stories about your uncle too? You know, I mean, you've been on the racetrack your whole life.
Probably the best story I can really say what happened to him and then my grandma's house. They were on Christmas Eve, so I was there.
Okay. Ward, I'm interviewing your brother on Sunday. Is there anything that I can ask him that only he'll know when I talk to you?
I thought you were going to come out of closet.
I think your dad's trying to get me in trouble.
Well, why don't you ask him about my dad?
Yeah, you can do that. You have to look out 5 years younger than I am. He didn't like a lot of the stuff I was doing when I was younger. He had this little cat in the house that was his cat. He did something outside that irritated me a little bit, and I had two beavers out there. I was skinning a foot deep in blood shooting these two beavers. I grabbed his cat and I said, look, I can skin this damn thing. You see that? He didn't mess with me anymore that day.
So are you and your brother still competitive?
Yeah, definitely. I mean, a brother will always be that way.
He's like, yeah.
We've got a lot in common in some ways, and some ways we don't have any common at all. Jeff moved to the city, I still live in the country. We're brothers, but I've got more in common with my little brother than I do with Jeff. At the same time, I care a lot about Jeff, and he gave me all the idea of going to. We just live in a little few different parts of life.
Now, you're the older one, right? You're the older, so after Sunday, do you still call him and say, what were you thinking when you passed so-and-so, or you couldn't pass, or do you like, still give him advice and stuff like that?
No, I don't. I mean, you know, how many of y'all are the oldest of the family? Right? Well, you know good and well, almost every family, the oldest has to go through a certain step, and the youngest is a plat, and an oldest is called silver. And I don't know what it is about family members that we've all done, but Jeff just had a little bit different silver platter than I had. At the same time, he worked really hard to get where he's at, but it's always seemed to be different than the older from the younger. No disrespect to the younger, but I've done the same thing. It is probably different.
Jeff, what goals have you set for yourself?
In my racing career.
In your racing career, yes.
My goal this year, I'll be taking over to win the next 5 races in the Camp World Truck Series. So my goal at Barnfield is finishing the top 15, and I think that is a big goal. And I really, really think that we're in the top 10 all day, and stay at the best. So I'm pretty pumped up about it, and get that second way to
come. Now, let me ask you, I mean, you're a great racer, but do you like this part of the racing, being a race car driver, like doing the interviews and stuff like that? I mean,
Well, it comes far with it, you know, so you got one. So you kind of got to go with it. So I like it. It's fun. It's something cool to do. It's fair. So you learn something that you can do. So I'm happy.
Now, Warren, what was it like the first time you ever came to Daytona and raced here? I mean, it has got to be stressful out there, hitting speeds like you guys are, and close to 200 miles per hour. I mean, it's got, do you remember the first time you came here? I mean, was it like white knuckled all the way around? And like, mentally stressful?
No, NASCAR slowed the vehicle down.
Wait, you just said slow them down. They're still going at speeds of about 200 miles per hour.
Yeah, you can run a whole lot faster than that. So, I mean, I know the first time I came here. This part right here was the same. This building over here, they didn't exist. What part was there was a lot smaller. This was the only way into the garage. It was still great and heavy. Hanging on it, it had the light on the top of it. It was the same 10 rod in the field that it was back in. It was ran senior first of all. Nothing would change. And I remember that so distinctly. And now when you go through it, you have the fans of it, you've got different types of handling brands. remember those old grassroots plays. This is certainly a pretty long. The racetrack was always at a job where you felt like, man, is that all the time? You know, you never took that fast.
Ashton, I have to ask you, do you have any dreams of being a NASCAR yourself?
Yeah. He's gonna be a lawyer.
You're gonna be a lawyer? Is that what you wanna be? What do you wanna be when you grow up? Where did we go with that? That's the first time I've ever asked a young man, and he said a federal agent. That is awesome. Actor, okay.
He's gonna be acting in Paris.
How old are you, Ashton?
10.
10 years old. And Jeb, you are?
19.
19 and now already driving. Do you remember your first time here in Daytona?
I don't remember the first time.
Is it
nerve-wracking?
You know, Ward, you have a great sponsor. They've been with you for a while, and that's State Water Heaters. I mean, do you have a great relationship with them? And I mean, you have them on the truck today.
Yeah, we've been doing a lot the last 4 or 5 years. We've been doing a lot of customer events at my foundation property. Driving experience for their customers, so that relationship is kind of evolved and they need support. So hopefully we can come up with some measurable programs that make it worthwhile for their customers and their brands and future customers.
So I'm going to ask you and I'm going to ask the two boys, and this will be able to wrap things up, but do you guys have any other talents than just racing? Go ahead.
I'm pretty damn good.
You are? Are you better than your dad? You do get your good answer. Okay. Now, does your dad make you work? Is that it?
Yeah. I have something to make
a lot of money. Do you have any other talents besides just being a great race car driver?
Well, I don't know about any great race car driver. I think I was good. I probably
Ward, you still have a fan base. When I just bring your name up, people go flipping crazy. Look at this. I mean, come on, man. I'll
tell you what, that's always making me feel very humble. I appreciate that. You know, I listen to Bruce all the time. Southside Virginia would love to drive today. I'm no better than you all, and I really could never stand somebody to talk that day. You work better than somebody else when I was there. I'm one of those guys, I wouldn't be watching that good in school. Even like in science, I couldn't understand how I could put the science class in something that was real. But if I would have thought I could have learned about the forest and the swamps and the mountains and all the minerals or something where I live, I would have gotten the best of science. So I'm the type of guy, if I'm interested in something, I'll give it 100%. But if I'm not interested in something, I'll take care of that, but I have to do it.
They say that behind every good man there is a better woman. Is that the truth? And what goals have you set for yourself, young man? We know you want to be an agent and do a great school. Do you play any other sports besides karate?
I am training soon.
Awesome! Come on! That is awesome! You should be very proud of yourself for that, because I wasn't. So, Jeff, just real quick.
Went out the other day, he shot my AR-15, so,
wow.
We're glad that you shot the room.
Was that at the house? Do you live on that big of a farm?
That?
Two Oh, okay. Gotcha.
Yeah, he corrected
I'll be in school by a 10-year-old. That's his foundation. I love it. Jeff, did you play any sports in school at all besides, you know, being racing and stuff like that?
I played baseball.